This next-gen demo is presented by State Farm.
All right, here at the Vivid Touch booth, Rev 3 Games at E3. We're about to talk about The Evil Within, which is the new game from Bethesda, and more notably from Shinji Mikami's studio. We have Pete Hines of Bethesda here to talk about it. Is it fair to call this game survival horror?
Yeah, in fact, Shinji refers to it as pure survival horror. It's a desire on his part and the team's to take survival horror back to its roots, so it's not quite so action heavy and it's all about guns and mowing down legions of things. It's more about scarcity of resources and balancing action with other things, whether that's storytelling or simply survival, running away from stuff, trying to get around things, solving puzzles, all of those kinds of things.
And this game, we can start looking at some of it here. It does evoke probably the last great survival horror game, which was Resident Evil 4, that Mikami himself did work on. I mean, is he aware that there are some strong similarities in many of the elements of it?
Yeah, I mean, it's one of those things, we've talked about this before, like it's really hard if you're a Shinji or a Todd Howard, like how do you not have some of the influences of stuff that you've made show up in the next thing you make? Like, this is his sort of ultimate survival horror game, so of course it harkens to some of the things, but at the same time, I think he's also trying to do some new things and some different things because, you know, things that, honestly, Adam, things that scared people 10 years ago, 15 years ago, like blood and guts, used to scare everybody, and now it's so common in everything, like you can't rely on that anymore.
And thankfully, with the heightened fidelity now available from these gaming machines, you can have things that look as gnarly as this right here. What is the context of this sequence?
So you're seeing stuff here from actually very early on in the game. You play Sebastian, who's a police detective. You've gone to an asylum where the police have been called for this terrible thing that's happened. You show up, you get knocked out, and then you wake up here and you're hanging upside down amongst in this little meat factory, and a guy goes by carrying half a torso.
As we're talking, you said the beginning of the game, which would read to me, it probably gets only worse from here.
Yeah.
So now, in terms of just looking at this, this is a pretty clean HUD, and I've seen quite a bit of this game. Is he trying to keep the screen kind of free of the clutter, which was quite endemic to a lot of old survival horror games?
Yeah, no, actually, this is not like where we've turned the HUD off. This is actually what it looks like to play the game in this part. So you saw a little prompt show up there to tell the player to swing back and forth so you can grab the knife to cut yourself free. But otherwise, like, this is what it looks like to play the game. He wants a very clean experience. You see, again, a little prompt for certain things to the player. And it's also maybe hard for folks to tell, but it's presented in a different aspect ratio. So this is 2.35:1. It's a CinemaScope ratio that where you actually can't see the floor. You don't see the floor when you're just walking around playing as much as you're used to. And so it gives you it's a very different vibe and sense.
Well, it's almost you're trying to create some tension by, you want to kind of crane your neck to get a little better vantage point.
You'll notice, like, when Sebastian opens doors, like, he does it really slowly, and there's this weird thing where Sebastian can see through the door before you do, and you're kind of, you catch yourself, like, leaning, trying to see what he can see when he walks through and opens a door. So he's just trying to do, again, this is what Shinji's great at, is he takes what the team is doing, and then he just adds little things here or there that heighten the tension, heighten the drama, and the suspense. That much more.
Now, obviously, a lot has changed just in games, and kind of the position of a lot of Japanese game publishers has shifted probably over the past decade. I mean, is the fact that he's working with Bethesda, I mean, is that giving him certain opportunities? I mean, I don't even want to tout the virtues of your company, but I'm trying to say in the hands of an American publisher.
No, there's no benefit to working with us.
I walked right into that one. But I mean, is he getting certain freedoms that maybe he didn't get when he was at Capcom?
I think it's twofold. Number one, I think he was looking for somebody who was willing to support him in making the kind of game he wanted to make. I also think he recognized that, look, like, as a Japanese developer, there's things about Western games which are becoming so much more popular and prevalent and kind of dominating the industry that he wanted to learn about and understand more and get more of our feedback to what he was doing. And like, how do I make a game that appeals across a wider audience, like that appeals to more people and not just a Japanese-centric audience. So I think we've been able to do that, you know, as part of our standard process, where like guys from other studios will play each other's games and then send back notes like, hey, I like this, I didn't understand that, like I got a little lost here. So Shinji gets the benefit of Bethesda Game Studios and Machine Games and id and all these other studios providing feedback to what he's making and saying, I like this, I didn't understand that, and is able to take that feedback into account.
And Evil Within, what consoles is it going to be available on?
So it's PC, Xbox 360, Xbox One, PS3, PS4 coming out next year.
A little generous. You're spreading the welfare.
Look, honestly, our thing is always for the game that, like, as the game as it's designed, we want as many people as possible to play it. So any console that sort of supports the game as it's envisioned and intended, like, we would love to put it out. We just want as many people as possible to play our games.
And it's coming at an unspecified time, but next year.
Next year.
All right. Pete Hines, thank you so much for your time.
Adam, always a pleasure.
All right, talk to you soon.